Our first guest is considered to be one of today's most respected interior and product designers. He's influenced the style of millions around the world as part of the Emmy-winning show Queer Eye for the Straight Guy.
Do you know what minimalism is? Minimal is like real clean. This is bleak.
You know, I wanted the house to have a little bit of fun, but mix it in with these more traditional pieces.
Ooh, another dazzling piece of artwork.
I have two cats, and I wanted to actually put a cat run. You know how cats like to climb over.
That's a really, really, really bad idea.
Well, since then, he shared his expertise on the Style Network, HGTV, and Bravo, as well as in books, magazine, and in home decor collection. Here to offer professional tips on how to transition your home from summer to fall, celebrity interior designer Thom Filicia. Good morning, Thom.
Good morning, Deborah. Wow, that was a blast from the past. I loved
hearing it. And just as funny today as then, you're like, that's a really bad idea. All right.
That is hilarious. Yeah.
When you look
that
at your
is
back-
so funny.
Yeah, when you look at your background, there's no surprise that you're in the business that you're in today. Your mom was a real estate agent, so you got to see all kinds of homes, even though you didn't always access those homes with permission. Explain.
No. Oh, no. So my mom actually, so when I was growing up, I was learning, my dad was teaching me how to draft and all this other stuff. My mom was a real estate agent, and she had this key in those back in the olden days with a lockbox key. And I used to steal her keys and I used to go into houses and just like check them out and like, you know, and really just kind of give myself house tours all over the place. And so that was kind of an intro to sort of like seeing many different homes from modern to traditional, you know. I lived in an area with beautiful old homes, and then I would go to the next suburb, which was all modern and contemporary. So it was really, it was actually a lot of fun.
Yeah. You would actually critique those homes. You're basically staging before staging was cool.
Yes, exactly. I was doing it virtually in my head, so it was very affordable at that time.
All right, so you finally got your degree in interior design from Syracuse.
Yes.
Explain the difference between an interior designer and a decorator, because I have a friend who keeps telling people, she goes, I'm an interior designer. I'm going, no, you're not. You're an accounting major. And she goes, no, but I like to decorate, so I'm an interior designer. That's kind of a different girl.
Yeah. Well, I think, you know, so I sort of think design is design, but I do think that, like, you know, in the business of design and certainly in the education of design, their designers are trained professionals in the space who have, you know, who are accredited and actually sort of look at space and interiors and decor and sort of work all of those things together. So when you're designing a restaurant or a home, you're really starting from the sort of the bones and moving forward. Decoration is really focusing mostly on decor items like soft furnishings and pillows and accessories, wall coverings and things like that, things that are much more just about simply the decor. So we do all of that in my design firm. And you know, we do homes from the ground up. We do full renovations. We do interiors. We do, of course, furniture design and all different products from rugs to wall coverings and all of that. And we're published in, you know, we're in AD this month. We're in a bunch of different magazines and always publishing, which is something that we love to do. And sort of, you know, let people know sort of what we're working on and exciting new projects that we're completing. So it's always fun. So yeah, I think you can go on to ad.com right now and see one of our projects that we just finished. And also,
what I love about it too is that, you know, so many times people want to change their surroundings and they think if we can just move, you don't really have to move. You can completely change your whole mood, the whole style, decor by just doing some simple things. And so you're sharing with us today how to transition from summer to fall, which can give you a whole different feel.
Yes.
Starting with edit. Some of that stuff got to go.
Well, I mean, first of all, we have two more days in September. I mean, it's October. So the holidays are amongst us. It's kind of crazy. I can't even believe we're here right now. This summer moved so quickly for me. But yes, I think of editing as not just something you do in the spring. It's something I do spring and fall, getting ready for the holidays. It's really about after the summer, really looking around and bringing it down to just those essential things that you really need to have to move forward into the next season, because there's so many things that are going to be start to accumulate from holiday decor to just all of the things that we're doing in this new season. And so I like to employ things like trays and boxes to really organize all of these things and keep it so that it's somewhat movable and it's you know, multifunctional. Homes for us right now, we're still using them for everything. We're still, there's going to be the education component. There's going to be where a lot of us are dining at home more than we ever have. And we're, you know, we're working from home more than we have. And then of course it's our homes where we go to relax and all of that. So you want things to be easily accessed, put away. You want it to look great when you have all of these things together. Also, another great thing is when you're editing is put things into groups, really bring things into these wonderful groupings that make them feel sort of very easy to understand. It just looks beautiful. It keeps things organized. And it's a really great way. I love things.
And a perfect example of that is like if you have several candles, instead of all these candles all over the place, just put all the candles kind of together on that tray that you talked about.
And make a bigger impact with that moment and do something that's really kind of like, wow, that's really beautiful. It's a little sexier. It's a little bit more of a, it's a little bit more of a wow moment.
Yeah.
Than having these things sort of all.
And then layer and lounge. But I love the layer because layer means I don't have to put it away in a pantry or something. Like I can just go ahead and that blanket just can be laying out, but looking pretty at the same time. I don't have to fold it up and put it someplace.
Absolutely. Well, I think I approach going into spring and summer with really about editing and keeping it clean and lean and rolling up the rugs, editing your pillows, taking things away. And this is that time of year where you can start to say like, hey, I want it to have a different vibe. I want it to feel a little bit more textured, more layered. You want to layer pillows. You want to layer throws. You want to bring in faux furs or, you know, faux goat skins. And you want to sort of have those layers and make it just have that different vibe, that different sensibility. And as you're going into all of the different holidays and gathering, you know, the way that we do around those types of activities and that time of the year, having those layers, it really plays to sort of the way that we want to dress, that we want to feel. It's the vibe. It's just sort of setting the stage for this next sort of chapter, this fall, winter kind of experience. And I think, you know, I love that sort of transition because it just, you feel it, even those subtle little things that you add on your sofa at the foot of your bed, layering rugs in the living room or layering things.
And see, I love how you make it a decor thing. I make it a storage thing. Like, you know, rugs can be big and in the way. It's hard to put them away. So I just, the other day, I was like, where do I store this rug? Because I love changing a rug out. And I just put the rug, the new one, on top of the old one. Nobody knows. They just go, oh, this rug is so cushy. It's like, yes, it is, isn't it?
And by the way, you can also layer it. So you can layer it so you're seeing the other rug.
Right.
And you're getting both of those textures, not just hiding it, which is also really nice.
Well, I had to hide it because I went a whole new direction. I went a whole new direction. I had to hide that one. But let me end with this one too, that is so easy to do, but again, changes the whole mood of the room. Yep. And that's, you light up my life. Lights, lights, lights.
You give me hope. But yes, exactly. Light it up. I always say, you know, again, you know, bringing in sort of great lighting in a room any time of the year is super important. Now the days are going to be a little bit shorter, and we do sort of entertain both indoor and outdoor. And of course, in Houston, you're going to be doing both now that you can. But when you're inside, even outside, having those layers of lights, not just that one overhead light in an outdoor space, or not just that one overhead light in a room, you want to have lighting from the floor to the tables to, you know, to overhead and into, of course, ceiling, you know, lighting. So you really want to have the lighting working in concert with candlelight, natural light being brought into the space. But I love uplights under trees or on either side of a sofa or either side of a sideboard.
Go with it, right? Just go with it and have fun with it. Hey, Thom. I want to thank you for lighting up our life today. I want to thank you for lighting up our life today. And we'd love to have you back sometime. But thank you very much for joining us. All right.
Thank you, Deborah. Big kiss. Happy fall.
Happy fall. For more on Thom Filicia and his interior design tips, just log on to greatdayhouston.com and we will connect you.